guys, I was just going to do a quick video today just of what you should take for a day case for surgery. In this case I did go for breast augmentation and I've also gone for scar revision surgery, which you can see in sort of my story and things from my previous videos. But I haven't seen a video like this on YouTube or anything, so I thought I'd just give you guys a heads up and see if it helps you. So generally when you do go for a day case, you sort of need to arrive there by about 7-8 in the morning, and then you do leave sort of about 4:30, so you pretty much do need to take things for a whole day. So things I would recommend to take with you, first of all, would be a pillow. Now they class them as sort of V pillows, you can get them in Argos. I did actually pick this one up on the way. I got this from WH Smith just at a service station on the way. Cost me about £4 or so. And pretty much what you do is you put it around your neck like that, so when you're sleeping, so you lift your head back. Just stops you from wriggling around, because depending on obviously what type of surgery you're having, if you are having breast augmentation or anything, you do have to sleep upright for about a week and a half or so. So that was very useful. Next thing I would recommend is to take some sort of sugary drink. So most people recommend to take Powerade. It does have to be the still version. I probably wouldn't recommend sugar, the fizzy version, sorry. But to take something like that, and then also some sort of food that is sugar, just to build up your sugar levels and things like that, just obviously once you've had the anaesthesia and things like that. Next thing, depending on what type of surgery you're having, I would recommend to take if you're having sort of breast augmentation, I would recommend to take a surgical bra, which will be something like a Macam. These bras, when I did research them, they seem to be the ones mainly that surgeons recommend as well. And I can just show you, I do have a black and a white one. I'm currently wearing the white one today. I am sorry, you can still sort of see my bandages, but let me just show you what they sort of look like. So they, because they do come quite low, they do sort of roll up and things. As you can see, they've got a little clasp there, and you can also do it up there if you want it up tighter. And there's a little bow there just to make it a bit cuter, because it is a bit boring and a bit big. But they have those in a black and a nude colour. Then I would recommend for a day case, definitely make sure you take like your magazines or your iPad or something, just to keep you occupied, because even though they do have TVs in the rooms, they don't always work. So I would recommend to take something like that. Next you'd want to take sort of socks or slippers or something, just because obviously when you're working down to the surgery room, or you're just in your room and you want you to keep your feet warm, so I found those really useful. Next you want to make sure you take your dressing gown. When you are walking down to surgery, even though you do have sort of the, what are they called, those sort of dresses that you have to wear, where they have the back open, it just protects your modesty and things, and also just keeps you warm whilst you're waiting as well. And then the main last thing I would just say is just take toiletries. So I took things like baby wipes, I took my toothbrush just in case, just everything that you pretty much would think that you would need. I did take baby wipes because when they obviously do cut you open, they use sort of that yellowy orangey thing, just obviously just to make sure you clean everything before. And after you do come out, that stuff does get everywhere, so the baby wipes are a big hand. So yeah, those are the things I would recommend. I will be doing another video on pre-op tips, and what type of questions you should ask if you're going to meet the surgeon for the first time. And I will also be doing a video on post-op tips, just on what you should do, what type of things to keep an eye out for, sort of if you're, generally they say after 6 weeks or so you can start using oils like bio oil, and things like that on your scars, or what type of things you could use. So I will be doing that video quite soon, within the next couple of days or so. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Again, I am only new to doing videos, so I'm just getting the hang of it. But thanks for watching, and I'll see you in my next video. Thanks guys, bye.